In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you. With your spirit.
Good evening.
Good evening, Helen.
We celebrate today the feast day of St. Benedict, abbot and patron of Europe. We gather together to remember his life of holiness and dedication to God. And so, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind us. I confess. God, who made the abbot St. Benedict, an outstanding master in the school of divine service, grant, we pray, that putting nothing before the love of you, we may hasten with love with a loving heart in the way you come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
He set me free.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
Jesus said to him, I tell you solemnly, when all is made new and the Son of Man sits on his throne of glory, you will yourselves sit on 12 thrones to judge the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone who has left houses, brothers, sisters, father, mother, children, or land for the sake of my name will be repaid 100 times over, and also inherit eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Aired on BBC World in around 2005. It was called The Monastery. It was based upon the monks and their lives at Appleforth Monastery, and they invited 5 people from secular life to come and join them for a few weeks to get a knowledge of their way of life. It was an excellent series, and I think it's still available on YouTube. What I loved about it was the way in which the people came into the monastery and had their own preconceptions about what monastic life was, but left with the radical change. And I remember when I was in Bristol having my hair cut, some years later I was sat next to a chap and we were talking, and I said, you seem very familiar. And he said, oh, I was, you might recognize me from a TV documentary. It was one of the people who was in the documentary, The Monastery. And I remembered him very well. The monastic rule of St. Benedict is the foundation of many religious orders, and many religious orders today still use remnants, if not all, of that monastic rule. It's a very simple rule of prayer, of study, and of work in that beautiful cycle in which the Benedictine monks work. And St. Benedict introduced this rule first to a monastery not far away from Rome, where he was studying. In fact, the rule was deemed to be too strict by the monks he was with, and they tried to poison him. But he left, and he founded a new monastery in Monte Cassino. And that monastery became a famous place of the Benedictine orders and spread out throughout the rest of the world, including our diocese, where we have 2 monastic foundations, Downside and Prinish. Let us pray that we may follow that simple rule of prayer, of study, and of work, knowing that through these actions, whatever our prayer, wherever our prayer takes place, whatever our work entails, and whatever we study in the life of the Church, will have the benefit of us having that promise of eternal life that Christ mentions in the Gospel this evening. St. Benedict, pray for us.
So let us turn to the Lord with our prayers of intercession this night. We pray for the Church, maybe especially on these days of Benedict, we pray for the Church in Europe, that it may continue to be a means in which the Gospel may be proclaimed. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our world in its many needs, for peace and reconciliation amongst the nations. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray today also maybe for all those Benedictine communities throughout our land and throughout our world, especially here in Clifton. It's very, very especially for the monks who are in Prinish, and the limited connection now with Downside. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for those who are sick in mind and body, that they may find healing and peace in the midst of their lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask for the prayers of Mary, Mother of God, pray with us before us as we sing.
Amen. For grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. May we use all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth is given, and human hands have made, will become for us the bread offered.
Blessed
be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all
his
Church.
Be kind, Lord, with these holy offerings which we made in honor of St. Benedict, and grant that by following his example and seeking you, we may merit the gifts of unity in your service and of peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For as on the festival of St. Benedict you bid your Church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your prayers, as without end we adore.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of holiness. Make holy the gifts we pray, descending down your Spirit upon them like the beautiful, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim the death of the Lord and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters
who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Benedict, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
But Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, you dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be
thy name,
thy kingdom come,
thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Love God.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Love God. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Love God. You take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy, and you should enter under my roof, but don't say a word, and I shall fall from you.
Amen.
Having received this pledge of eternal life, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, to tend to the teaching of St. Benedict, we may faithfully serve your desires and love one another with fervent charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is.
Thanks be to God.